Hi friends, welcome to today's video. So today again we are having a syllogism question. So our question is, some crows are hens. All hens are peacocks. No peacock is a minor. So these are the three given statements. And the three given conclusions are, some crows are definitely not minors. No crow is minor. No hen is a minor. Okay, so let's try to solve this. So the given statements are, some crows are hens, all hens are peacocks, no peacock is a minor. So we have to start with the all statement. So that is the key. You have to first start drawing from the all statement. So all hens are peacocks. That means let hens be represented by this circle. So since all hens are peacocks, the hens circle will be coming totally inside the peacock's circle. The pink circle is representing the peacocks and blue circle is representing the hens. So all hens are peacocks. So hens circle will be coming wholly inside the peacock circle. Now what is given? Some crows are hens. Some crows are hens means what are the different possibilities? One possibility is it can come like this. Okay. Now second possibility is it can come like this. The cross circle is wholly inside the peacock circle. So these are the two ways in which cross circle can come, either by this yellow circle or by this red circle. Now no peacock is a minor. That is the third statement given. No peacock is a minor. So how to represent that? So no peacock is a minor means it can come here. The minor can come here. That is one possibility. Or minor can overlap with this crow. Some of the minors can be crows. So that is, this is first circle, this is second circle. So M1 and M2 are representing the two ways in which minor can come. Either minor is not crow, hen or peacock. Second one, the minor can be crow. So that is the second possibility. Okay. Now let's go to our conclusions. First conclusion, some crows are not, sorry, here not is not there. So some crows are definitely not minors. So that is the first conclusion. This is representing crow. Okay, some crows are definitely not minors. So let's see the yellow circle. Yellow circle is one possibility for crow. In the yellow circle, there are some crows which are not minors. Yeah, these part of the crows are representing which are not minors. Okay, this green part will be representing the crows which are definitely not minors. Now take the second case of crows. Second circle is red circle is also representing crows. Second circle also all the crows are not minors. Okay, second circle fully it cannot be minors. So some crows are definitely not minors is satisfied by both the circles. Both this yellow circle and red circle are the two possibilities for representing crows. And both these circles will lead to the conclusion 1, that some crows are definitely not minors. So conclusion 1 will definitely follow. Okay, so that is our answer. The second is, no crow is minor. No crow is minor is true in the case of this red circle. In the red circle, no crow is minor. There is no overlapping. But this yellow circle, some of the crows can be minors. So that is one possibility. We cannot say the crows can be represented by either this yellow circle or this red circle. We cannot definitely say which of this will be represented by the question given or by the given statements. A cross can be represented by either this red circle or this yellow circle. If it is represented by the yellow circle, some crows are minors. So no crow is minor statement or that conclusion will not follow in the case of this yellow circle. So we can definitely say conclusion 2 is wrong. It should be satisfied by all the different representations. The conclusion should be logically following all the possible representations. Here this yellow circle is overlapping with minor. So we can surely say conclusion 2 is false. Now conclusion 3. No hen is a minor. So no hen is a minor. Let's see. Hen, there is only one way in which hen is represented here. And hen is not overlapping with minor. So conclusion 3 also follows. So conclusion 1 and conclusion 3 follows. Now let's go to question number 2. All footballs are basketballs and all basketballs are bats. No bat is ball, no ball is racket. Now first conclusion is at least some footballs are rackets. Second statement is some rackets are not footballs. And third statement is no bat is racket. So let's see. What are the given statements? All footballs are basketballs. Okay. So let this be football. Okay, so all footballs or basketballs means the football's circle will be coming wholly inside the basketball circle. So let the pink circle represent basketball. Again, it is given all basketballs are bats. So bat circle will be coming here. Okay, so all footballs are basketballs and all basketballs are bats. Okay, so that is over. Now next case is no bat is ball. Okay, it is given like no bat is ball. So this is bat. Okay, no bat is ball means there is only one possibility, ball can come here. There is no other way of representing ball because bat is representing the outermost circle. So no bat is ball means ball can only come here. There is no other way. It is given like no ball is racket. So what are the different possibilities? Either racket can come like this, that is one possibility, or the racket can come like this, that is another possibility, or racket can come like this, only overlapping with bats, or racket can overlap with bats and basketballs, or racket can overlap with all the three. So these are the different cases. Okay, R2, R3 and R4. There are four ways of representing rackets. Okay, so one is the racket can come outside. Racket is neither bat nor basketball and nor football also. So racket is coming here. Or the racket can overlap with only bats, or racket can overlap with only bats and basketballs, or racket can overlap with all the three. So these are the four ways in which rackets can come. Okay, now let's go to the first question, first conclusion. At least some footballs are rackets. So this is one possibility of racket. Okay, at least some footballs are rackets, we cannot tell, because there is one possibility that racket is totally falling outside these three circles, bats, basketballs and footballs, racket can come here. So since this possibility is not leading to conclusion 1, we can say conclusion 1 does not follow. All the possibilities should lead to conclusion, then only we can say that conclusion is true. But here there is one possibility that does not lead to conclusion 1. So conclusion 2 is false. Now what about conclusion 2? Some rackets are not footballs. Some rackets are not footballs. So you can say here no ball is racket is only given. Okay, no ball is racket is only given. So there is a possibility that this racket can come totally inside footballs. Okay, that is also one possibility. I told racket can overlap with bats, basketballs and footballs, or racket can overlap only with bats, and racket can overlap with both bats and basketballs, and racket can come fully inside the football. That possibility is there. We cannot tell that cannot occur. So some rackets are not footballs is also not true. If sometimes racket is fully coming inside the footballs means all the rackets will be footballs only. So some rackets are not footballs does not follow in that case. So second conclusion also does not follow. Now what about the third conclusion? No bat is racket. No bat is racket, we cannot surely tell, because there are many possibilities. Look here, the racket is overlapping only with bats. In that case also some bats are rackets. Or this racket can overlap with both basketballs and bats. In that case also some bats are rackets. And also if the racket is fully coming inside the football, or racket is fully overlapping with football, basketballs and bats also, that time also this conclusion 3 does not follow. So conclusion 3 is also false. So all the three conclusions does not follow from the given statements. Thank you for watching.